Google's Gemini AI image generator can not only generate high quality images like this, but it can also edit those images. In this video, I will be showing you how you can use Google's Gemini 2.0 to edit images. So let's get started. First thing, just Google Gemini AI Studio and click the first link and make sure that you are signing in with your Google account. And to the right, you will be having the model, and make sure that you are selecting Gemini 2.0 Flash Experimental under Preview. Select it, and here in the output format, also choose images and text so that we will be able to get images in the output. So first, you'll be having this plus icon. Go here and upload any image of your choice. So I have uploaded this image of a room, and we are going to like add new things in an image. For example, I will just go add a much bigger table with flowers on it. So this is going to be my prompt. Let's see what it gives us. Okay, look at this. This is the output image that we have got, and it has added a bigger table with a flower, and this is the old image. Here you can see a small table without any flowers, and it has literally kept all the other things in this image intact. That's what I like about this editor, because it doesn't disturb any of the surroundings. It only changes the things which we want to. So this is the first one. Let me just clear that. And it is also so good in text related things. So I've just given the prompt, add the text "Hello World" on his shirt, and run it. So this is what has happened. First, I gave this prompt, right? It got the "Hello World" perfectly, like, but the thing is, the heart was still on that t-shirt. Then what I did was, I just gave the prompt, remove that heart, but it removed entire thing. It removed the "Hello World" also. Then I again gave, now add "Hello World" text in a stylish font. So this is the output that we get. This looks perfect, like seriously. Like, look at the way the particular text has blended with the t-shirt, like the fold of the t-shirt also, like the curvy part of that "Hello World". That looks so good, to be honest. Yeah. So it's also equally good in adding text over any of your images. And now let's try with changing the theme or the night and dark mode. For example, here I am having a image of a valley in daytime, and I will just upload this particular image and ask it to give it the view in nighttime. So this is the night view that I'm getting. This looks stunning. Like, look at this. This is the old, you know, day view, and you can see so much of similarities. Like, there's a small structure over here, that is over here, and we're having this icy structure. The exact same ice structure is here, and we are having like the slant mountain over here, and we are also having that. So it has kept most of the features same, and it has given like accurate night view of this image. So that's totally amazing. Imagine doing this in Photoshop or any other app. It's going to literally take you so much of time. And another thing that it can do is colorizing images. For example, here I'm having a black and white sketch, right? So I'm just going to upload this particular image, and I'm just going to ask, add colors to it, or you can just put it, colorize it, and let's see what it gives up. And this is the output that we get. This looks stunning. Like, this looks like a cartoonish theme of this image, but look at it. It has literally grasped the color of Statue of Liberty. It could have literally given Statue of Liberty any color, but I don't know how it did it. It kinda recognized Statue of Liberty, that it's green in color, and it has perfectly given, including that flame. The flame is perfectly like in orange color, and yeah, it looks intact. So that's really good. In case if you're having any sketches, you can just give it and ask it to color it. And next feature is getting a different angle for a particular image. Here I'm having a like a front inclined view of a car, right? What if I wanted to get the side view? It can also help us with that. So just go here and upload that image and ask it, can you give me the side view? All right, and run. And look at it. It has perfectly given us the side view of that car. And look at it, the back tail, that aerodynamics thing, It is also perfectly given, and the front bumper, everything is so perfect. And in case if you want to have more modifications, like let's say example you want the door opened, so you can just ask open the door, that's it, and run, and we have got the door, both the doors opened. And another amazing thing is that here in the first image we had the interior seat color as red, and in the third image, as you can see here, the interior still remains red. So that's how it pays attention to small details. And literally with one image you can construct 3-4 images, back angle, side angle, literally everything from a single image. So this not only applies for like cars, you can do it with people, building interiors, a particular object. So it's really useful in getting different point of view and angles. And next, it's going to be a simple one. I'm just going to select this particular car and it's going to ask change the color, okay, to blue. Quite a simple one, and this is easily doable in Photoshop or any image editor. You can just going to pick that color and change it, but this also does the job. Yeah. And next thing is going to be clearing a particular object. For example, I'll just go here and upload this image. Okay, just go with this image. Yeah, this is basically an image where a lot of people are standing on the streets like this. So we have a lot of people like this on the streets, and I'm just going to ask remove the people from the streets like this and run. And look at it has done quite a good job, and but it didn't remove this three people. I don't know why, but apart from that, it has literally removed everybody. Like, you get this right, none of them are there, only these three people are there. Maybe you can just again ask it to remove them also, it will definitely remove. So this is also another use case, and I'm keeping the best use case for the last, these three images. Okay, so what you can do is you can also input multiple images. So I'll just go here and get these three, this pink sofa and the desk and this chair. Going to open it. So here I'm having three images, and I will just go and put all of them in a living room. All right, so just run it. This feature is going to be super useful in case if you are a interior designer, or in case if you have furnitures and you don't know what to do. So this is the output that we get. This looks so good. We have a living room, the sofa is there, the chair, exact same chair, and we are having the desk over here. And what if you didn't like the output? There is also a simple way. What you're doing is you're just going to click here, delete this, and you're having this edit option. Edit it, and you can change the prompt if you want to. If you don't want the prompt but generate a different response, you're having this stop editing and run the prompt option. Click that. Now it will regenerate the output for you. So that looks stunning. I guess it can't get any better than this. We have the sofa, that blue desk, and we have that exact chair. And what I really like about this is that it hasn't made any alterations. Like, look at the precise level, okay? So this chair, black in color, has some brown wooden frames. And look at here, black in color, brown wooden frames, exact same. And next we're having the sofa, pink in color, has this brown bottom thing, pink in color, brown bottom thing, and it has also added those pillows. That's amazing. And here the desk has this top thingy, I don't know what's it called, but it has this space on the top, and that has also been retained over here, that top space thing. That's how accurate it's descending, this particular arc thing also. So that's really amazing. This feature really blows my mind off. Yeah. And apart from this, it can also do other stuff, like in case you're uploading multiple images. So here I'm having a croissant and a person. I'm just going to give the prompt, make her eat this, and just run it. And this is the output that I got after correcting it. And this doesn't look bad, to be honest, like, because we haven't given a full image of that person. So this kind of looks good. She's like having that bread thing in her hand and she's like chewing it. So you just get the point, right? In case if you are uploading multiple images, it can literally combine that into a single image, and it does the job so well. So these are the use cases that I found, guys, and try it out and let me know in the comments what you think about it. I hope you would have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I run a lot of videos in programming and AI tools and tech in general. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.